ocean that I like.
My name is Eric Liner. I'm a cinematographer and producer at the Cornell Lab of Ornithology. I've been lucky enough to film in incredible locations around the world, and the sagebrush steppe is as diverse and wild and vast a habitat as any that exists on the planet. The first time I ever got really excited about filming sage-grouse was when the producer of Sagebrush Sea shared some older, low-resolution, black-and-white, high-speed imagery of a male sage-grouse display. It had been filmed for scientific purposes, but it revealed just how complex and dynamic the display was. You could see, you know, the air sacs inflating and deflating, and the body moving in a way that just resembled something so unlike a bird that I'd ever seen before. I remember thinking that we've got to get our hands on a high-speed camera, bring this stuff to life. To film sage grouse on the lek, you have to get up really early in the morning. Usually we'll try to arrive about 2 hours before the sun comes up. This is taking place in March. It's just crisp and sometimes clear and the stars are out. And you walk in the direction that you hope your blind is in. We walk out without our headlamps on. And sometimes finding your blind is a matter of just walking around in the dark for a while with your arms out in front of you feeling for something. As quietly and as quickly as possible, you get in there with all your camera gear and start building your camera. And then just wait. What's incredible is before that sun even comes up and you're so anxious to start rolling, is you start hearing males shuffling around and you start to hear the woofing and the thumping of their display, the booming starts. Sometimes it starts all around you and you realize that you're just surrounded by these displaying males. It's all you can do not to poke your head out and see what's going on, but you don't want to disturb them. So you just wait there and you just listen. As soon as you see those first rays of light start to spill into your blind and then wash on the lek, that's when things start to get exciting. You can slowly open the window to your blind and look out on the world, sort of assess where you are. If you're lucky, you've positioned your blind and yourself really close to sort of the alpha male, the successful male on the lek. Unfortunately, you can make mistakes and you can place your blind either too far away from the activity, or you might be right next to activity sometimes, but it's out a window or at an angle that you just can't get to. That's the worst. You're gonna sit there all morning knowing that that great behavior and activity is going on, but you just can't get a lens on it. The sage grouse is legitimately our North American bird of paradise. I mean, it's every bit as beautiful. Its display and behaviors every bit as stylized. It's this incredible marriage of, you know, sort of form and function and sound. It's like nothing else really in the world. To have sat in a blind at sunrise, at dawn, and listen to the displays starting as the sun comes up, you know you've seen something special.
The males inflate, tails spread. But beyond displaying, they're powerless. It's the female who holds the cards. To a spectator, males might all look alike, but the female...